Hi there, and welcome back. In this video, I will talk to you about the difference between the client and the server, and how you can get the server to execute your code. It is very useful to know how these two interact, since I didn't at first, and now that I think about it, a lot of errors I made could have easily been avoided. Since we use the API with JavaScript, all functionalities of this language can still be used, like arrays, strings, dictionaries, and so on. But since we're also dealing with cloud computing, new functions and variables must come in place to connect the client, which is your computer, to the server. Whenever you use objects or functions that also work in other regular JavaScript environments, these will get stored and computed on your own device, the client. But when you want the Earth Engine's servers to run code, you have to use server objects and server functions. These variables and functions are generally initialized with the double E, and these are the objects that will send the information to the server. So, for example, I can create two numbers, A and B. And I can perform calculations with this, for example, A plus B. And when I print this out, we should be able to get the result. So as you see, the console has printed the number. But when we look at the profiler, we can see nothing is there. No action has been taken by the server. The entire calculation happened on the client side. When instead we define A and B as server-side variables, we should be able to get the same command executed by the server. The server-side variable for numbers can be declared with the function ee.number. Capitals are important here, so watch out for that. And as you see, the double E informs that this is a server-side object. So we could try to run it like this, but it won't work. These variables are no longer numbers, but objects, and the plus operation does not recognize the objects. We can check the type of the variable by printing it. And indeed, we find that the variables are objects. When we want to add these two variables, we will have to call a server-side function, since these are server-side variables. We can easily find all the available functions by using the docs tab. There you find all server-side variable types, and by expanding them you can find all possible functions. So we'll go down to ee.number. And these are all possible operations for this type of object. In this example we wanted to add two numbers, so the function add should do the trick. And we can try to run this again. And now we have a number. This time we got the proper result, but the 8 you see is not just an integer, it is also an object. ee.number to be precise. But the print command is one of the few that can recognize Earth Engine objects and will give you a proper print. When looking at the profiler, we can verify the server's action again. And indeed, this time the server executed code. So the first thing that happened on the server is the algorithm numbers.add, and the second item, the plumbing, represents the transfer of data from the server back to the client. It is the safest to use server-side variables as often as possible, since mixing the two can cause problems. For example, if you write this piece of code, similar to the previous example, and we want to check if A equals 4. We will use another function. C should be set to false since the number A does not equal 4. But when we check for C in a regular JavaScript if statement, we find that it is still set to true. This happens because the comparison does not see the variable C as a value, but as an object, and it does not know what to make of that object. A print statement, on the other hand, or server-side function, does know how to interpret it and run the function. To do the same operation, a server-side if function should have been used. This is an important thing to note when you get started with the Google Earth Engine. I know it would have saved me a lot of time and frustration, so I hope I can spare you of this now. If you wanted to find more information about a certain function, you can visit the complete docs online. I'll put a link to that in the description. Here you find a manual with more advanced explanations and examples for the more common tasks. And the reference guide contains all possible functions similar to the docs tab. You can also find video tutorials here, but they're really long, often longer than an hour, and the quality is not always ideal. We'll come in contact with more of the different types of variables and functions in the following videos, so stay tuned for that.